Hello, I'm Dr. Saloni Nandan. I have a lesson for you on evolution of communication tools. The importance of communication in human society has been recognized for thousands of years. Throughout history, human beings have sought to improve their ability to receive and understand information and improve their methods for the transmission of the information. This video discusses the historical background of the field of communication and the evolution of communication tools, which will help you to have a clear understanding of what communication is all about. This picture is a simple illustration of the means of communication in the primitive age and the modern age. As the human race evolved and people moved to different places for the want of food, shelter, and as hunter-gatherers settled into small villages, and with the growing need for money, jobs, and education, the need for communication became more pressing. The ways of communication also changed with altering needs. Primitive communication was done by the use of disorganized signs and symbols on cave paintings and other forms of graphic symbols, including the pictogram. The colorful pigments that you can see on these cave paintings were made from the juice of fruits, berries, color minerals, and animal blood. These were used to create depictions of primitive life on the cave walls. What gave human communication a powerful scope and depth was the development of language. As humans became more and more organized, different kinds of languages and communication methods were developed. Around 1050 BC, Phoenicians developed the first common alphabets based on sounds, which allowed the uniformity of the language. In the Phoenician system, only the consonants were written, leaving the vowels to be understood by the reader. The first two letters in the Phoenician systems were alpha and beta, which were later borrowed and adapted by the Greeks. Long-distance communication was not based on written words, but drums and smoke signals were used, and even bonfires were lit in line on the hilltops. These techniques were only capable of conveying very limited pre-arranged signals such as danger or victory. With the alphabets and with the portable writing materials such as papyrus, clay, wax, wooden tablets, communication became easier and a part of daily life. Old manuscripts that were written on palm leaves are still preserved, and one can see them in our National Manuscript Library in Delhi. Written messages were sent through horse riders, but they depended upon good roads and favorable climate. Even home pigeons were used to send messages through short letters on paper. However, there were limitations attached with these kind of communication. These were insufficient means of communication, as one had to wait for someone to be traveling to carry the letter. There was no guarantee that the letter would ever reach its destination, and it took a lot of time too. But all these means of communication were essential for the survival of human beings who were organizing themselves in societies, and therefore they needed some method for interpersonal and intercommunal information exchange of information and communication. In 600 AD, Chinese with the wooden blocks to print letters printed the Buddhist scripture Diamond Sutra. The modern age of communication is associated with printed books made with the paper, ink, and a printing press, which rapidly displaced the manuscripts of earlier generations. With the advent of the Johannes Gutenberg's printing machine and an ink for printing which was oil-based and thus could not be easily erased, the printed texts were readily available to people. The first book to be printed was Gutenberg's Bible. In England, in 1468 AD, William Caxton produced a book with the first printed advertisement. In India, the printing technology came in 1556, and the first book was printed in Portuguese language. The first printing press was established in Mumbai in 1674. The second was established in Madras in 1772, and the third in Calcutta in 1779. In the 17th century, pamphlets were printed at mass level, which were easy to produce and which laid the foundation for the mass communication. The modern age has seen a tremendous development of new techniques and technological devices in communication. It was with the revolution of the telegraph that the instant communication across long distances became possible. Around 1895, Guglielmo Marconi and Alexander Popov succeeded in transmitting and receiving wireless messages. This technology was particularly useful during wartime to transmit important information. One discovery followed another. In 1876, Alexander Graham Bell invented the electric telephone to make communication across long distances quicker and efficient. During the early 1900s, a new form of communication and entertainment through radio took the world by storm. Approximately 2 million homes had radios, and there were several hundred broadcasting stations. Photography too became very popular means to capture image for eternity. Telegraphs, telephones and radios, people have now moved on to televisions, computers and cell phones. In the present digital age, the electronic media has made communication global and fast at the speed of light. The electronic media includes internet, television, e-newspapers, e-magazines, etc., which contain vast amount of information which can be transferred and received within a very short time. Nowadays, social media and blogging sites have had a significant impact on personal and professional communication and have increased the pace of life and improved the exchange of ideas. Thanks for watching the video. I hope now you know all the facts about the evolution of communication tools. So, bye for now.